Good day. Let me show you how to get most dynamic range, latitude and color depth out of the Canon R6 Mark II. Most of you already know that in order to get highest quality footage when it comes to dynamic range and color depth, you must use external recorder like the Atomos Ninja V or Ninja 5 Plus. What you may not know is that the 6K ProRes RAW output from this camera is 10-bit, which is the same as regular ProRes or C-Log3 for that matter. And if you want to get full advantage out of this setup, which is 12-bit ProRes RAW, you must use 3.7 crop mode and lose the 6K resolution. The 12-bit ProRes RAW maintains original pristine sensor data, ensuring that the key elements, which are high dynamic range and wide color gamut, are captured. It will give you greater latitude when capturing video with challenging illumination. It will add flexibility in enhancing portions of the available dynamic range. Let me show you how to set it up on both the camera and the Atomos Ninja 5. On your Canon R6 Mark II, go to the camera section, the red menu, and navigate to tab 8. Scroll to HDMI RAW output and turn it on. Then go to the first tab in the same red menu and enable movie cropping. In movie recording size, choose one of the options. You can also record 1080p backup to your camera SD card in C-Log3. After you connect the Atomos Ninja 5, it should automatically show your input, the gamma will display C-Log2, and the signal 3.7K. Make sure the ProRes RAW is selected in the Record tab and you are good to go. Strangely, the electronic level display disappears when HDMI is connected. This isn't the case with Lumix S5 II and the level stays on when connected to HDMI recorder. So, is it worth it? Is the difference between 10-bit ProRes RAW and 12-bit ProRes RAW enough to sacrifice the 6K resolution? And let's not forget that right now you can only take full advantage of ProRes RAW if you are Final Cut Pro user. If you are using Premiere, you get limited support, and if you are using DaVinci Resolve, you don't get support at all. You must buy third-party software to transform ProRes RAW to Cinema DNG and then import it to DaVinci Resolve, which is making all this workflow even more complicated. There's time and place for specific tools to be used. I don't think I will use the 12-bit ProRes RAW in my regular work, but I will keep it in my toolbox and use it in challenging situations. But how about you? What do you think? Or are you already using the ProRes RAW in your regular work? Please, let me know in the comments and check out my other videos about Canon R6 Mark II. See you there.